Checo, welcome. Bienvenidos, bienvenidas to the last event of the North Country Art, Land and Environment Summit.
On behalf of the North Country Art, Land and Environment Summit, we wanted to thank all our collaborating partners, the people, the organizations and the land and the water that made this summit possible.
We also want to thank the funders who made this program available to you. We want to thank Humanities New York and the National Endowment of the Humanities, as well as the St. Lawrence University Arts Collaborative Grant and the Richard F. Brush Art Gallery. We'd also like to thank the North Country Public Radio and the Weave News for being our media sponsors and for hosting this event. And without further ado, we're going to pass the word on to Satyogwa, who will give the closing address, closing last event of the North Country Art, Land and Environment Summit for all of us.
Hello, everybody. My name is Satyogwa. I'm Snipe Clan from Akwesasne. It's where I was born and raised. I quickly did a short closing for everybody in our Mohawk language. I first started out with all the people to, I hope that there is still peace between everybody. Then I moved on to the Mother Earth and give her greeting and thanks that she continue to carry everything set down on this earth that helps support one another. And then I turned to the waters and the fish and the green grasses, our gardens, our trees, our plant medicines, that they still continue to flow and grow and support us. And then I turned our minds towards the sky and everything that dwells in the sky, that the birds still fly and that they still continue to sing their songs. To the four winds, to the four beings that they still watch over us, to the thunder beings that they continue to make their rumbles and clean the waters. And then I thanked the stars that mark our way if we ever get lost, and the sun and the moon, that they still shine down on us and that we can still see them every day. And then to our creator, that he put down all these things that help support our lives, and it's our duty to support them as they support us. And also that I was closing the matters that are at hand. And I'd like to say a big thank you to everybody who participated, and I hope everybody enjoyed all the topics that have been discussed. So, yawa.
Niawa, thank you. Thank you so much, Satyagwa, for concluding this summit for us and for, at the same time, setting the stage with your words, with this concluding address for this conversation to come, this conversation in which we connect this region with the world. Niawa, thank you.
Thank you. And we would like to begin by acknowledging that the land on which we gather is the traditional territory of the Haudenosaunee peoples, specifically the Ganyangaaga Mohawk. In addition, those of us who are part of the colonial society acknowledge our role as settlers on this territory, honoring those who have stewarded this land since time immemorial.
We also acknowledge the history that we are a part of, us as co-organizers of the North Country Online Environment Summit, but all of us who live on this territory or territories around the world. In the case of where we stand, we live in a land that has been partitioned, that has been cut up, divided between settler colonial states. In the case of here, where we are now on Haudenosaunee territory, the land was cut up between England and France, now between United States and Canada. The border between the States and Canada divides this land. It runs right through the St. Lawrence River, runs right through the Akwesasne Nation, dividing the Mohawk, Ganyangahaga people between two colonial states. In acknowledging the violence of this history, we also want to acknowledge the present moment. We are now living in a climate crisis, a moment in which the lives of all are dependent upon a society which is rushing forward towards a very ugly, destructive end. However, we hope that we're fighting for a collective future, a collective, sustainable, and just future for all. And in that, and with under that lens, we want to also talk about us, how we came to this land, our positionality, because both of us are not from this land, Haudenosaunee territory. We are settlers on this land and acknowledge that.
For this reason, I would like to do a personal land acknowledgement from the land I'm originally from. Since I have acknowledged this territory and the people that have stewarded it. So I come from the mother nation that since 1861 has been called Italy. How did Italy come to be? And I want to talk about this for the land acknowledgement because as I realized that I wanted to do a land acknowledgement, I realized it was not easy to talk about Italy and what that land means historically and for me personally, my family personally. So I want to say that in 1861, Italy came together under the modern nation that it is now through an extractionist colonial act from the industrialized north towards the still feudal south. This act is affecting Italy to recent time because of an economical division that has split the country in two. And this act has brought, has unified a very young nation under a language that was constructed, that is in a way another colonial act. So as we often say in Italy, we made Italy, but we never made Italians. This union has brought a huge cultural loss. And I want to acknowledge another kind of cultural loss that has affected particularly my families on both sides. I want to acknowledge the migration that has affected Italy and its land, and that has brought to having large portions of the countryside becoming ghosts and ghost towns. And it is this migration that has brought my father not to be born in Italy, but in Germany, because his family had to leave the land because it couldn't sustain them. Also, I have family, a branch of a family in Belgium, still in Germany, some of it here in the United States, and some of it even in Argentina. So I want to acknowledge those people that left their land, and some of them that never went back. So you can imagine the cultural loss that the land has suffered from those people that could never go back to their families when they left. And I want to conclude this land acknowledgement of mine by reminding all Italians that are still in Italy or everywhere in the world to remember this migration and what it has meant for our land and its history. And when it comes to judge other people for migrating to Italy or anywhere else, to remember that we have experienced it and thus act accordingly.
And something I wanted to reference, your name is?
Blake Lavia.
My name is Sibu. Mi nombre es Sinsun, como se dice en español. However, my name comes from an origin which is not the place that is on my passport. I have two passports. I have an American passport, quote unquote American, the colonial state of America, United States of America, and I have a Mexican passport. So again, I, like Blake, I come to you as a settler on this land. Yeah, my heritage comes from way back, from other lands and other territories. Part of my family also comes from Italy. This placed by waves of migration that also have robbed my ancestors of their history and of their collective memory. Another part of my family comes over to this land, to this continent, as the conquistadores, who have raped, pillaged, and committed genocide. And another part of my family is Purépecha, Purembe. That's where my name's from. My name Sinsun or Tsiwu means hummingbird in Purembe, Purépecha. And I want to acknowledge those histories, those lineages, my family that comes from multiple places, multiple geographies, as we all stand here, Blake and Tsiwu. And we think it's important to mention this, because in talking about any future, we need to acknowledge who we are and where we stand. And now, talking about a little of what we covered in the North Country Art, Land, and Environment Summit. We delved into the St. Lawrence River watershed. We talked about the water, the waterways that run like veins through this land. We talked about the food systems and food sovereignty and why that's important, especially now in the time of COVID-19. We talked about environmental justice and issues of environmental racism that are present in this region, in what people call the North Country. We also talked about our environmental futures and the future that we all hope for this region, a future in which people recognize that Black Lives Matter, a future in which people consider everyone in this territory as part of this land and is recognized as this land, a future that honors the stewards of this land, the indigenous nations that have lived in this land, a future which looks towards a sustainable world, a world that is not governed by the multiple pandemics that are ruling this world currently. So in discussing this, we are presenting ourselves to you all as storytellers. We are filmmakers, but as filmmakers, we are only doing our small part in telling the stories and changing the narratives to fight for a just and equitable, sustainable future. And these stories and these narratives that we are sharing with you all are not just regional, the St. Lawrence River watershed. They're also global. So right now we're going to tell you an international story that crosses boundaries and crosses borders. We have with us tonight, they're not visible, but they will come on soon, people from around the world who will share with us their struggles, share with us so we can collaborate, so we can connect, and in this very drastic time, we can create a unified narrative of resistance and change. So without further ado, we're going to introduce to you, coming for us from Germany, it's extremely late on his end of things, so it's amazing. Thank you so much for joining us, Tobias Rem from Climate Connect.
Thanks for the great opportunity, first of all, to present. And while talking about global collaboration, that's exactly what we want to achieve at Climate Connect. And I want to now tell you a little bit more about it. So our vision is really, first of all, to accelerate climate action globally. And we want to do it through collaboration because humanity is really great at working together, and we want to take advantage of that in fighting climate change more effectively. And the next goal would be that we want to really bring everyone together onto one platform. So we want to be a platform where everybody who is involved in fighting climate change can sign on and collaborate with others. It doesn't matter where you're from or what you're doing. The only single thing that matters is that we all want to fight climate change. To achieve those goals, we have set some values that we think are necessary to fulfill, to achieve these goals. First of all, we are completely open source. That means everybody can have a look at our source code, can see what we're doing with your data. Secondly, we are free and non-profit, so it's completely free to join the platform so that everybody can get involved if they want to. And we are non-profit, so we're running completely on donations, and we don't do it for the money, we just do it for the cause to fight climate change. Also, the platform is completely driven by the community, so the community can really decide on what the next steps will be, which functions should be implemented, and how the platform works overall. And maybe most importantly, we are completely independent from any big organizations or anyone who could influence us. So those are like the four pillars that Climate Connect is built on. Then maybe the question comes up who we are. We are a team of three co-founders. And overall, we have about 15 amazing volunteers from three different countries who are helping us currently developing the platform and also growing the community. How it works is quite simple. You can sign up on climateconnect.earth and you can share your actions. It doesn't matter if it's like a really big project or if it's just only an idea, you can sign up and create your own project page, which then gets shared with all the other people on the platform. If you don't have your own project yet, you can also just have a look at all the projects that are already on there. You can just get inspired by all the stuff that's being done about climate change. If you want to collaborate with others, that's a great place to look for running projects that you can get involved with and that your skills are most helpful for. So with every project that has been shared on Climate Connect, there are skills associated with each project, and you can just filter for skills to find the right projects that suits you and that is the most effective thing for you to work on. So now I've got some little visuals for you where you can see how the page is built up. So this is the main page where all the climate action projects are shown, and with a little preview, and where also your project will be shown if you share your own projects. So there you can have a look. You can just browse through all the projects. You can also filter for special projects. For example, if you look for something near you, you can filter for your location, or you can filter for specific types of projects or different categories. And then the special thing is if you want to get involved, if you want to leave some tips or just talk about the project, you can directly contact the project owners through the platform and get in contact with them that way really easily. And if you have shared your project on the platform, this is what your page could look like. So first of all, you have a little summary to understand really quickly what your project is about. And then you have the possibility to put in a longer description to add some skills that you're maybe looking for. So if you, for example, want to create a website, but you don't know, no idea how to do it, here's the place to put in the skills that are required or that would be nice to have if someone wants to collaborate with you on that project. So if you want to join the platform, feel free to do so. It's completely for free, as said. We would be more than happy to welcome you all to our global community at climateconnect.earth. And if you get any questions, just let me know. You can contact us all at contact@climateconnect.earth or my personal email address, tobias.rodem@climateconnect.earth. Not that easy to say, and I hope that you get a really nice event this evening and have a lot of fun. Thanks.
Thank you so much, Tobias, for joining us. It is probably extremely late there. I hope you have an amazing night. And again, if you have any questions for Tobias about Climate Connect, about anything of that nature, his email was right there. We will be putting all of the emails and contacts information in a slide at the very end of the event. And we will also put it in the different chats, whether that be in YouTube or in the Zoom chat at the very end of the event. Thank you so much, Tobias.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
And moving on, we saw some people, amazing people, that were trying to weave together connections globally to create a global moment of resistance, to fight for our collective future.
And so now we're gonna talk a little bit about what we as filmmakers and documentarians have been doing. About 1 year ago, we started this project in which we're working right now, that is documenting Earth Guardian across Turtle Island, North America. This project is called Burning or Breathing, and as I said, it features Earth Guardians, which are people that are working relentlessly to protect their environment and their communities in different capacities. Burning or Breathing has taken the shape of a collection of short documentaries that are being hosted on our website, but that we soon hope to create a larger website that will become an encyclopedia of knowledge that goes against the doomsday rhetoric that we're also used to hear, that there's nothing that we can do to save our environment and to preserve this planet for future generations. So we are creating this encyclopedia of people that are doing the complete opposite of what we believe is impossible. They're succeeding in protecting their communities, their land, and their environment. And also we hope through this website and through these videos to connect struggles, because oftentimes we find ourselves caught into these small bubbles these bubbles that cannot be escaped. And through this website and these videos, we hope to bridge the gaps and for people who are working separately to join their forces for our futures. This March, Siwa and I went to Veracruz, Mexico, right before the pandemic hit this part of the globe. And we talked to a number of amazing people who have been working to protect the environment of the Antigua River watershed. And we have compiled a number of documentaries, and tonight you'll see one of them. And it's about a farmer from Xico Viejo, and she is working with Sendas. And tonight we have Gina Vidriales-Chan that will talk a little bit more about what they have all been doing to protect the land through farming and other kind of work. So now we're gonna show you a video of Mercedes, and then Gina will talk more about all their work.
Thank you. Mi nombre es Mercedes Cortés Melchor, soy de la comunidad de Cuatitila, municipio de Jicobet. Nos encontramos pues en esta bella comunidad. Ay, como quién más decir, ¿no? O sea, mi comunidad, ¿no? Nosotros estamos viviendo en la parte donde del terreno de mi esposo, ¿no? O sea, del que pues los papás le heredan a los hijos. Y aquí era un potrero. O sea, esta parte era un potrero donde andaban las vacas y todo. Inicia esta experiencia que ha nacido a través de sendas, inicia más o menos un año, en la cual nosotros, antes de esta bonita experiencia que estamos viviendo, solo orgullosamente me llamo ama de casa y solamente nos enfrascamos a veces en nada más en eso, ¿no? O sea, soy ama de casa, atiendo a la familia, atiendo al marido. Y eso es lo que hacía antes de todo esto. ¿Cómo surge esto? Esto surge a través de esa motivación que gracias a la organización Sendas nos ha dado, ¿no? O sea, de motivar, de saber lo que tenemos a nuestros alrededores, de saber lo que tenemos en nuestros campos, de saberlos valorar. Ahora, con el apoyo de ellos, hemos nos han dado talleres, nos han dado capacitaciones en las cuales nosotros podemos saber más acerca del campo, cómo cuidarlo, cómo cuidar nuestro medio ambiente, nuestras tierras, cómo podemos mantenerlas fértiles.
Es muy importante para nosotros cuidar lo que es nuestro medio ambiente, ¿no? Lo que es nuestro medio ambiente conlleva a agua, o sea, nuestras tierras. ¿Por qué? Porque vienen más generaciones, ¿no? Ellas son en las que debemos de pensar también y en su momento pararse, detenerse y decir, ¿qué estoy haciendo? ¿Qué estoy haciendo por nuestra madre tierra? ¿Qué estoy haciendo por el agua? Nosotros optamos por reforestar, o sea, por mantener los árboles en nuestra madre tierra por basta de agrotóxicos. ¿Por qué? Porque sentimos que si nosotros nos enfocamos en hacer eso, como que dañamos y nos preguntamos qué cosa le vamos a dejar el día de mañana a nuestras futuras generaciones. Hay vecinos que sí como que tuvimos que poner un alto porque sí usaban mucho agrotóxico e incluso los vecinos pues tienen sus terrenos acá, no viven acá, pero sí tenían sus terrenos acá. Ellos empezaron a cultivar papa, pero papa que le aventaban un buen de agrotóxicos, pesticidas y todo. Tuvimos una experiencia muy, muy, muy mala, ¿no? Porque sí dentro de esto, pues morían las aves, las gallinas que también nuestros vecinos tenían y pasaban por ahí, los manantiales, o sea, todo eso se consume y se van nuestros manantiales. Pero nosotros tomamos la decisión de como comunidad decir alto, o sea, ¿qué cosas están haciendo? Más aparte, teníamos la escuela enfrente y decir, o sea, basta, lo que están haciendo no está bien.
como vuelvo a lo mismo, ¿no? O sea, con ese testimonio que nosotros damos, dicen, ah, no, pues sí, o sea, está bien, ¿no? Entrémosle. Y hay vecinos que sí se están sumando. Acá está una muchacha está trabajando igual su macrotúnel. Y pues ahí vamos, ¿no? O sea, yo siempre he dicho, o sea, trabajar nosotros, primero demostrar que sí se puede con nuestra familia y todo, y después dar el testimonio a los demás, que de lo demás viene solo porque sí funciona. O sea, sí tenemos nuestros retos y todo, pero como comunidad, el diálogo, el yo te cuento esto, tú me cuentas qué pasó, cómo te va, o sea, como intercambio, ¿no? De diálogos, y bueno, eso es lo que podemos hacer, ¿no? O sea, con testimonios. Mi sueño más adelante es de obtener una biofábrica de mis propios insumos para poder llevar esto, para sacar adelante mis hortalizas, el área de la milpa, o sea, todo eso. A veces dicen, no, el que no arriesga no gana. Y sí, a veces tenemos altibajos como todo, ¿no? Pero arriesguémonos, preguntemos y atrevámonos a hacer cosas nuevas, porque sí se obtienen muchos resultados en unión a la familia, en nuestra buena alimentación, en unión hacia los demás y en una armonía, en vivir con una armonía con los animales, con todo lo que conlleva nuestra madre naturaleza. ¿Por qué no vivir en armonía con ella? Y sí se puede, y sí lo podemos lograr. Y yo siento que unidos los hacemos más.
Without further ado, we're going to pass you to Gina Vidriales Chan, who is from the group called Sendas, and she's going to take you away and explain more about all the work that Mercedes has been doing.
Hello, everybody. I am Georgina Vidriales Chan, and I live in the Pisquiac watershed that is located at Central Veracruz, Mexico. And I work since 2003 with a local NGO called Sendas. And since 2005, we have been working in alliance with local actors in the promotion of the territorial planning with a watershed approach. And since then, an overall of local solutions has been articulated, all related to enhance and strengthen public policies to incorporate environmental services programs as an integrated scope. Related with the cities that are around this watershed, that are Jalapa and Coatepec. In the past, there are multiple learning from successes and failures. We have a shift in different aspects of the complex reality that approach this implies. We have do a lot of work with scientific knowledge, restoration, conservation, ecosystem services and environmental supply services. Also work with productive alternatives and biomarketing, all these related with the watershed management. Also, we have been working with a lot of organizational networking, research, awareness, participation, multi-actor platforms, public policy making, and we have been looking for long-term financial programs to support all this work with this watershed scope. But also, we have been working a lot with the capital of the state, that is Jalapa, that is related to this area, to protect the resources and also to make the city more resilient, because we hope that if we can transform the cities, we also can protect the watersheds, the upstream watersheds. Also, we do a beautiful project that is called Piscando, that is a community support agriculture scheme that connect rural areas, rural family with urban areas, linking the consumption and production. That's the way Mercedes does. The lady that you saw at the video is one of these producers. And we make arrangements, medium-term arrangements, to support this way of living also. And we have the double benefit of healthy food and also healthy environment and the support of the family of Mercedes and other 20 different families. Additionally, we work with alternative water supply systems in the city, also incorporating the climate change and the vulnerability of social environmental vulnerability. All this work, that is a lot of it, no, that is resumed in a few words, is done with a beautiful team of 16 people. We work at Sendas, and we are trying to incorporate the local sphere, and the challenge is still to incorporate this complexity into the public administration to change the paradigms of water management from the organization in the cities and supply areas. So we are fighting for make more participation schemes where public and private can be together, which allow transparency and permanence and enhance the well-being of the city and the surrounding rural areas that are at the watersheds. So that is what we do at Sendas and how we do it. Thank you all.
Thank you so much, Gina, Georgina Vidrales-Chan, for sharing with us your work. And again, Blake described to you a little bit about what we did. And we were just, again, humble storytellers, following the people that are working on the ground to make this change happen. And how? By looking at the wide picture of a watershed, of all the waters that flow together and join as the veins of this land, and then in this case, that flow all the way from the state of Puebla and then flow through the state of Veracruz and end up in the Gulf of Mexico. So we're talking right now about the Antigua watershed, La Cuenca de la Antigua. This land is a powerful land with many diverse ecosystems, lots of people who are living in cities and rural communities, like what you saw with Mercedes. The water that flows by Mercedes's house that she is protecting flows downstream to cities like Jalapa, like Otepec, and then continues south, continues down until it arrives at towns like Jacomulco, Veracruz. And it is these towns that have fought to keep this river, to keep this watershed free from large-scale hydroelectric projects that would, one, destroy the livelihood of many by drying up the land, drying up the farming land that feeds these communities, and also protected this ecosystem, these vital ecosystem for generations to come. So right now, we are going to introduce you to PUCARP, Pueblos Unidos de la Cuenca Antigua por Ríos Libres, the United Communities of the Antigua Watershed for Free Rivers. And this collective successfully beat back both the Mexican government and Odebrecht, and a Brazilian company that constructs dams throughout Turtle Island, throughout the Americas. And this collective is one of those success stories, one of those success stories that is very rare in the mainstream media about people that actually manage to protect their land and environment for the future generations. So without further ado, we're going to present to you Alex Gallardo, who's representing the collective at the moment and will share his story.
Buenas tardes para nosotros acá. Es un placer estar con ustedes este día compartiendo un poco de nuestra experiencia vivida. Mi nombre es Alejandro Gallardo y pertenezco al colectivo Pueblos Unidos de la Cuenca Antigua por Ríos Libres.
So, thank you so much for having me here. Thank you so much for letting me share this experience of my life and my movement. I am representing the Pueblos Unidos de la Cuenca del Antiguo por Ríos Libres, the United Communities of the Antigua Watershed for Free Rivers.
Bien, en nuestro caso, somos un colectivo, es decir, lo agrupamos muchos pueblos, también muchos colectivos hermanos, muchas organizaciones, gente de todas partes del país se identifican como Púcar, incluyendo gente del extranjero, se identifican mucho con nuestro movimiento.
So we are a collective of multiple towns and multiple communities. Communities are united together under one common cause. Even people from other countries consider themselves to be Púcar, to be part of this movement, to be part of this collective organization.
Estamos en defensa del río Antigua o Huitzilapan, de la cuenca antigua Huitzilapan, desde el año 2010, por las intenciones de construir hidroeléctricas. Se dice que en el estado de Veracruz están proyectadas algo así como 112 proyectos hidroeléctricos.
So we are right now in the Cuenca de la Antigua de Huitzinapan. We're right now in the Antigua watershed of Huitzinapan, in a place that, in general, they say in the state of Veracruz, Mexico, they have 112 hydroelectric projects that are planned. And we are right here in this place, in this watershed now.
El proyecto en cuestión se llama Propósitos Múltiples Jalapa y estaba pensado llevarlo a cabo esta empresa brasileña muy conocida mundialmente por sus escándalos de corrupción. Es una empresa muy poderosa con muchos, digamos, elementos económicos muy, muy potentes y muchas relaciones con gobiernos directamente apoyando, financiando campañas políticas. A cambio de favores y de llevar a cabo sus proyectos, ¿no? Con intercambio. Es una empresa muy, muy poderosa a nivel mundial, ¿no? Entonces, primero que nada es conocer quién es la Odebrecht y contra quién estamos peleando.
So, to let you know, which is the company that is imposing on us this dam. We also want to acknowledge the name of this dam, which is the Multiple Uses for Jalapa, which is a dam that was planned, that wasn't implemented, but was almost put to block this river and this watershed. The company in question is Odebrecht. It's a Brazilian company that is very famous worldwide for multiple scandals. And this company is a monster that was breathing down our throats.
Bien, el proyecto en cuestión tiene que ver con generar energía eléctrica, evidentemente, pero también llevar agua a Jalapa, ¿no? Ese era uno de los argumentos importantes de este megaproyecto. No obstante, el error muy, muy, muy grande es no tomar en cuenta a los pueblos, no informar debidamente cuáles son las condiciones de un megaproyecto de este tamaño, y tampoco se informó que alrededor de un proyecto de estos tiene que haber pueblos desplazados. Es un tema importantísimo.
So this dam was envisioned, one, of course, to project to create electricity, but also for water for the city of Jalapa. But what was not done in the planning and the implementation and the proposed implementation of this damming project was to inform the communities that will be directly affected by this dam, that will be displaced by this dam, or that their water source that feeds their land would be cut by this dam.
Esta cuenca antigua es rica, evidentemente todo Veracruz es rico en agua dulce, es el que agrupa la mayor concentración de agua dulce prácticamente del país, y la cuenca antigua es riquísima y alberga más o menos a 1 millón de personas distribuidas en todo alrededor de la cuenca antigua. Entonces, evidentemente, esta empresa quería de alguna manera venir a imponer sus métodos, sus modos, cuando la cuenca antigua ha persistido durante cientos de años viviendo en armonía con el río. Y lo que pretendían hacer era matar el río, tapándolo y evitando que corriera su cauce normal. Eso para nosotros es antinatural.
So this river, the Cuenca de la Antigua, and then all of the riverways that flow into the Antigua watershed, hosts and keeps a vital and very varied ecosystem, a diverse ecosystem alive. Also, more than a million different people live alongside these waters, depend on these waters. And what the damming project wanted to do was to block these waterways, dry up the region. And for us, this was unacceptable.
En realidad, el tema del proyecto no está cancelado. Nosotros como pueblos, como Jalcomulco y muchos pueblos vecinos, tuvimos que poner un campamento permanente que se llama Centinelas del Río, que vigila la entrada, justamente el acceso al río, para que la maquinaria destructiva, demoledora de la Odebrecht no pueda entrar nuevamente. Tenemos grupos de guardia custodiando la entrada del río desde el 2014 a la fecha, y eso es una decisión que han tomado los pueblos a falta de información veraz, oportuna, de parte del gobierno. Y los pueblos se manifiestan ahí y dicen no a la construcción de hidroeléctricas en nuestra cuenca antigua.
So, the project is not dead. It is currently pending. So, we have made a decision. The collective of all of these united communities has made a decision to have a guard, a peaceful guard that is placed in the site where they were planning to start the construction. We call this camp, because we've made a camp there, the River Sentinels. And from 2014 on, we have been there, we have been guarding this land, we've been guarding this river.
Cierro diciendo que para nosotros, como Pucar, este grupo que se formó justamente para hacer frente a este megaproyecto impulsado por la Odebrecht, para nosotros el defender el río es defender la vida en todos los sentidos que ello confiere. Por eso estamos ahí, por la defensa de la vida, por la defensa de nuestra casa común, que es el planeta Tierra. Gracias.
So, speaking for the collective, speaking for Pucar, I want to say that we're defending the river and the water because the river is life. The river is life for us all. So, in conclusion, I want to say that we are defending this vital resource which provides life to all planet Earth. Thank you.
Gracias.
Thank you y gracias, Alex Gallardo. Gracias por compartir con nosotros tu movimiento. Thank you, Alex, for sharing with us about your movement and the powerful and transformative actions that have helped shape your region. So right now we're going to show a small video that we put together in collaboration with other filmmakers from Jacomulco, in which you see a little, in very broad strokes, the force of this movement.
El agua de la tormenta y estremece.
there you saw a little bit of what this amazing movement has done and it continues to do to protect the river, to protect the Antigua watershed. And the water that flows through this watershed, again, flows into the Gulf of Mexico, has this confluence with the Gulf of Mexico. And along the banks of this river, we see communities that have united to protect the waterways. People like Mercedes, Meche, who manage through agricultural farming to protect the rivers that flow by her house. People like the friends from Pucar in Jacomulco, who managed to block large hydroelectric projects. So now we're going to pass you on to another voice.
We're going to pass you on to Jose Alfredo de Moral García.
A mis hermanos y hermanas del mundo, ustedes, tejedores de conciencia etnosocioambiental.
To my brothers and sisters in the world, to my weavers of social, ethno-environmental consciousness.
Nuestra lucha es la lucha del mundo. Nuestros ideales van a preservar nuestro planeta. Nuestra voz es la voz de la tierra.
Our fight is the fight of the world. Our ideals are going to preserve the planet. Our voice is the voice of the planet.
Nos hemos peleado tanto por el medio ambiente, pero es precisamente por el daño causado al planeta que debemos tener en cuenta su preservación, ahora que estamos cerca del punto en el cual o tomamos acción o no habrá retorno.
We have been worried so much about this environment, but it is the damage that we have caused to this environment, the reason why we need to preserve it now. And it is now the time to take action.
Es necesario voltear a los bosques, esos grandes ecosistemas con una distribución restringida y una gran biodiversidad, ya que están altamente amenazados por el cambio de uso de suelo.
We need to go back to the forest, the woods, that are these very diverse ecosystems that are very much endangered. And we need to preserve them.
Seamos conscientes de nuestra vida dentro de un mundo cada vez más acabado y direccionemos hacia el retorno a una vida socialmente ética. Es la hora de liquidar esa deuda con nuestra gran de acabar el hambre, de seguir por el sendero del uso de la razón, de reaprender y resaltar el conocimiento de nuestros ancestros. El tiempo es ahora.
We should be conscious about the life that is inside of this world and is being finished. We need to change our direction towards a return towards a socially ecological world. We need to liquidate the debt we have with our Mother Earth. We need to finish with the hunger. We need to continue on the path of reason. We need to relearn. We need to accentuate the knowledge of our ancestors. The time is now.
Las causas de estas crisis están relacionadas directamente con acciones y hábitos de países con acumulación de riqueza, políticas que no llegan a tener impacto en nuestra social, grandes grupos empresariales vendiéndonos el consumo excesivo, ofertando la creencia de que tener más es vivir mejor, pero la producción contaminante a todos nos perjudica, acrecentando cada vez más una deuda a nuestras vidas.
The causes of this crisis are all related directly with our actions. The actions and the habits of the countries that have just accumulated riches, the politics that have an impact on all of our lives. Big businesses selling us consumer accessories, offering us the myth that we can live and enjoy these riches without suffering the consequences. But this production has only contaminated our world, has only put all of us in danger, making our debt to this world bigger, a debt to our own lives.
Somos muchas cuerdas vocales y debemos escuchar, porque unidos somos la voz de la tierra.
We are many vocal cords, and together we need to make ourselves be heard, because united we are the voice of this earth.
La educación es, sin duda, la herramienta por excelencia a la que debemos apelar y fortalecer para contrarrestar los efectos que acarrea el consumo excesivo y sus consecuencias. De enseñarles que el aprovechamiento productivo, extractivo, excesivo e inconsciente de recursos naturales renovables y no renovables, que nos quita la seguridad de seguir en pie. Y como colegio de profesionales de la educación, haremos lo que está en nuestras manos.
Education is without a doubt the best tool that we have to make this fight and to strengthen our movement, to push against the effects that have pushed this world to the breaking point, to fight against the excess exploitation of our natural resources. We need to teach a productive way of interacting with the world around us that is not extractive and that is not, and that is sustainable and that honors all of the resources, renewable and non-renewable, which also makes us live a secure lifestyle. We are the collective of professionals in favor of education, and the future lies in our hands.
Nadie está solo, aunque parezca que todos están en nuestra contra. Todas las luchas son importantes. Ninguna debe discriminarse. Todas debemos unirnos y respetar, porque cada uno sabe y conoce las causas justas.
No one is alone, even if this world makes you think so. All of the struggles are important and vital. We shouldn't discriminate between any of them. Every single struggle needs to unite and respect each other, because we all know that we're fighting for the correct thing, we're fighting and we're on the correct path.
Y seguiremos responsabilizando a los políticos de todo el mundo por el mal manejo de nuestra tierra, lugar que debemos respetar con el corazón humano y no con ideas de consumismo.
We will keep the politicians in check so that they, the politicians of all the world in check, so that they manage the lands correctly. They need to respect and use their heart and not the driving force of consumption.
Juntos por una causa justa y noble, nuestra tierra no está a la venta. No más el cambio de suelo, no más represas hidroeléctricas. Sí a la vida, sí a preservar nuestro hogar terrestre.
Together, we fight for this just and noble cause. Our land is not for sale. No more exploitation. No more hydroelectric dams. Yes to life. Yes to protecting our Mother Earth.
No existen fronteras cuando del medio ambiente se habla. Muchas gracias.
Borders cease to exist when we're talking about the environment. Thank you. Gracias, Jose Alfredo. Jose Alfredo is currently fighting to protect the forest of Coatepec and the world. And now, without further ado, we'll also introduce the last person that's joining us from around the world tonight. We'll also introduce Alejandro Beltrán Cordero. We are all talking about these movements that unite people. And right now, this is what we're trying to do. Right now, tonight, we're uniting in a confluence of movements and energies, the environmental building blocks to which we can all create a sustainable future. So without further ado, Alejandro, if you could join us.
Hola, soy Alejandro Beltrán. Soy narrador de historias. Y tejedor, trato de conjuntar a la gente de 500 movimientos de resistencia que hay en el país.
Hello, my name is Alejandro Beltrán Cordero, and I'm a storyteller, and I'm trying to weave together a lot of fights and endeavors in this country.
Gracias. Tengo una décima, que es una forma de poesía tradicional aquí de la región que me gustaría compartir.
So I have a poem, una décima, which is a traditional form of poetry, and I would like to share it with you tonight.
Me gustaría concluir contándoles una historia.
I would like to conclude by telling you a story.
Una con sabor a gloria para verle sonreír.
One that tastes like glory, so I can see you smile.
Para verle sonreír con lo que voy a decir.
To see you smile after you hear what I have to say.
El mundo ya se acababa, ya todo se terminaba y ya moría la esperanza.
The world was ending. Everything was finishing up. And hope was dying as well.
Terminaba hasta la danza y el mundo entero lloraba.
Even dancing was ending and the entire world was crying.
Cuando una abeja se aproxima hasta el cáliz de una flor.
When a bee approached the chalice of a flower.
Y de ahí nació el amor y también nació la rima, la esperanza se aproxima.
From there, love was born. Rhyme was born as well, and hope approached.
Suenan zumbidos, tambores.
Buzzing and drums played.
Aullidos, cantos, colores, los pueblos que se levantan.
Howls, songs, colors, the people that stand.
Y que a la vida le cantan sus cantos conmovedores.
And that life sings to them their moving songs.
Es el beso de la vida lo que aquí se está formando.
It's the kiss of life, the one that's forming here.
Y juntos vamos luchando. La tierra agradecida nos ofrece la acogida.
Together we keep on fighting and the thankful land offers us its bounty.
Ya el futuro se despeja. Hacemos una madeja y a la madre protegemos.
Already the future clears. We weave together our struggle and the mother protects us.
Hoy por ella danzaremos. Somos los pueblos abeja.
Today for her we'll dance. We are the bee people.
Nosotros aquí tratamos de proteger a las abejas nativas de todo el continente. Gracias.
Here we try to protect the native bees for the entire continent. Thank you.
Gracias, Alejandro. Thank you, Alejandro, for sharing that powerful poem with us, bringing everything together, all these movements together, in the image of a small bee. A powerful, beautiful being, a beautiful being that brings life to this earth. And so right now we're going to use that image, that metaphor, to conclude. A metaphor of pollination, of life, and of growth. All of us, in every single little corner of the world where we all stand, and the territories where we all stand, or just like those little bees. We're there, we're buzzing away, doing our own thing, fighting on our own struggles. However, united, we can make the world buzz with our song. United, everyone from Pucar to Meche and Georgina from Sendas, from Alejandro, from Jose Sajorin, and all the other amazing people that we saw from this watershed, from La Cuenca del San Lorenzo, from the St. Lawrence watershed. All of us are uniting to make the world dance, to make the world sing, and to change the narrative. Because like this, we're changing the narrative. Like this, we're saying, yes, we can. Yes, we can fight for a new world. Yes, we can be that kiss of life, the kiss that creates the beautiful futures, that spark, that seed. We got a question from Sarah Ashpole, and what continues to bring you hope? What role does the youth and elders hold? Entonces, tenemos una pregunta para ustedes. ¿Qué les da esperanza a ustedes? ¿Y qué papel pueden jugar los ancianos, pero también a los jóvenes, las jóvenes de su comunidad, en crear esta esperanza? Entonces, ¿qué esperanza? ¿Qué les trae esperanza y cómo pueden jugar los niños, niñas y los ancianos en esta imagen? Entonces, primero, si quiere empezar, Alejandro, ¿qué le da esperanza? What brings you hope?
A mí, lo primero que me da esperanza en esta región es la lucha de todos los pueblos. Lo otro que a mí siempre me ha dado esperanza es ver a las abejas que siguen trayendo polen. Sí. A los niños que se acercan ahora sin temor a las abejas.
So for Alejandro, what brings him hope is the fact that in the region where he is, that all of these united communities are joining together to fight. And also, something else that brings him hope is the bee, the little bees that he sees continue to bring pollen, and the children that watch the bees without being afraid. Entonces, Alex Gallardo, ¿qué le trae esperanza a usted y cómo pueden otras personas jugar un papel en crear ese nuevo futuro?
Bien, me trae esperanza la organización de las comunidades. Estoy viendo un cambio muy positivo en cuanto al cuidado del medio ambiente. Hay cada vez más colectivos que hacen cuestiones de permacultura, bioconstrucción, generando nuevos colectivos de jóvenes que están estudiando la prepa, la universidad. Eso me da mucha esperanza. Y por último, agregar que el trabajar en este cambio de generación con los jóvenes es vital, es fundamental. Nosotros aprendimos mucho de nuestros abuelitos, de nuestros padres, y nos heredaron este sentido de lucha y este sentido de pertenencia al lugar donde habitamos, ¿no? Entonces, con eso me quedo.
So, something that really inspires Alejandro from Jacomulco. One is the change that he sees in his own community, everything from the youth that are learning in high school and beyond how to practice different sustainable practices such as permaculture, and also another thing that inspires him is all of the young people that are fighting to make a change. And just as he learned from the older generation, from his ancestors, from the older people in his community, just as he learned how to be an advocate for this world, he's inspired by the younger people that are learning also from them to fight for this land. And Georgina?
Well, what brings me hope? A lot of things, it could be sound trite, but we can share the knowledge between the elder people with the younger people, because they listen, elders and younger, they have earrings for each other, so they can hear each other and learn about them. We also can go through the barriers and make changes. And as Alex Gallardo says, there's a lot of people now joining to these eco-movements, no? And it's a new way of looking through the new challenge of being citizens of the world. So that makes me really hopeful about the changes.
Thank you, Gina. And now, José Milán, I'm going to introduce you to, te voy a introducir a todos porque la gente no te conoce todavía. So I'm going to introduce José Milán to everyone. José Milán is part of PUCAR. He's part of the collective that has been defending the rivers of La Antigua. So, bienvenido, welcome. Entonces, la pregunta va a ser, ¿qué te da esperanza? ¿Qué te da esperanza para este futuro? ¿Y cómo pueden incluirse en esta lucha los jóvenes, tanto jóvenes como ancianos?
Hola chicos, muy buenas tardes. Primero que nada, una disculpa por el pequeño retardo. Ustedes saben que trabajo en el río y justo estoy saliendo ahora de este trabajo. Nada, la verdad es que mis esperanzas están puestas en, en las generaciones futuras, en la juventud. Yo soy padre de un niño de 10 años y la verdad es que cada vez que escucho hablar a mi hijo, cada vez que lo veo jugar en el río, divertirse, disfrutar de la naturaleza y saber que estoy sembrando una semilla en él, y además con los niños de la comunidad, con los que de repente me desenvuelvo y veo que hay ahora muchas generaciones que vienen atrás de mí haciendo el mismo trabajo, es para mí muy inspirador. Y ver todos los días cuando amanece las montañas que están verdes, el río que sigue corriendo, para mí representa muchísimo. Yo siempre lo he dicho, para mí el río representa vida, porque me da vida a mí, porque le da vida a mi familia, porque le da vida a toda la familia que tenemos en el planeta, todos como hermanos. Y creo que los movimientos deben de ser uno solo, ¿no? Al final, como decían, no es que un movimiento es muy independiente al otro, creo que todos estamos conectados, no debe de haber fronteras cuando de naturaleza se hable, como lo decía. Creo que mis mayores esperanzas son esas, están puestas en las generaciones futuras, pero también es importante recalcar el trabajo que hacen las mujeres y los adultos mayores en este tipo de luchas, porque si bien es cierto, la lucha de Jalcomulco, de Pucar, del río La Antigua, estuvo muy respaldada por ellos y yo creo que se merecen un aplauso muy fuerte, porque sin ellos no se hubiera hecho mucho. Y bueno, muchísimas gracias por este espacio también.
Gracias, gracias José Milán. Te voy a traducir lo mejor que puedo porque no sé si recuerdo todo. So I'm going to translate everything that José said, just summarizing it. So what inspires, well, first he apologized for arriving late. He was working in the river, working in El Río de los Pescados, in the River of the Fishes, which is the name of that river there. He then started to say that what inspires him is even looking at the future generations, looking at his child play in the river, looking at the children become part of this land and of this movement. Also, he's inspired from everything from looking up and seeing the sun come over the mountains, the sun rays coming over the mountains, all these little things that make up life and who we are. And also, he wants to reiterate that the importance of connecting these movements, into a unified whole, because when it comes to the fighting for the environment, there are no borders. And finally, he also wanted to say very clearly how everyone's been part of this fight, from children to elders have been part of this movement and this struggle, and without them, it would not have happened. So he thanked us. We have another question for you all. Tenemos otra pregunta para ustedes. Entonces, la siguiente pregunta es, ¿cómo pueden mantener su salud psicológica, su salud física, mientras están haciendo ese trabajo increíble y muy importante que hacen todos los días? ¿Cómo pueden mantenerse sanos mientras luchan por la planeta Tierra? Y de nuevo voy a empezar con Alejandro.
Okay, gracias. Con música, con fandangos, con versos, con cuentos, con canciones, con pinturas, todo eso es lo que nos permite seguir sanos de esa manera.
So, gracias, Alex. So I don't know if you all, I said the question in Spanish without saying it out loud in English, so I'm going to say it again out loud in English. So how do you keep your physical and mental energy high to do the work that you do? So what Alejandro said was with music, with song, with dance, with fandangos, which are these parties that are specifically centered, that specifically come, there are fandangos all over the world now, but they come originally from the region where they are, in Veracruz. And this type of unification of music and art that makes one live and makes one happy and keeps one healthy. Gracias, Alex.
We have to start with the family. We have a healthy family, con la familia, with the family. Also, eating healthy, no? Comiendo sano, without food that is, how you say, libre de pesticidas?
Via pesticides?
Uh-huh. No pesticides in the food. And also with the hope that is going to change. Something has to change and we have to move forward together. So that's the way we can stay.
Gracias, thank you, Gina. And now, Alex Gallardo. ¿Cómo puedes mantenerte sano haciendo el trabajo que haces, luchando por la tierra?
Sí, es una buena pregunta. Al inicio de nuestro movimiento, sufrimos mucho estrés. Casi no dormíamos. Fueron como prácticamente un mes muy intenso, de muchos choques de emociones y demás enfrentamientos. Es complicada, ese primer mes es muy complicado. Sin duda, como dice la compañera Georgina, la compañera Gina, que es apoyarse mucho de la familia. En el caso de nosotros, la camaradería, como dice Alex Beltrán, es parte de nuestra manera de ser acá, ¿no? De los jarochos, de los veracruzanos, en general de los mexicanos, pero a nosotros nos ayudó mucho, nos llevamos muy bien, nos tenemos mucha confianza al interior del colectivo, del movimiento, y sin duda cambiar los hábitos alimenticios ayuda un montón, mucho. Quiero decir, a manera personal y el desarrollo de personal y de mis compañeros, fuimos sufriendo un cambio, una metamorfosis cuando ingresamos al movimiento como tal y en el desarrollo del movimiento. Tuvimos que decir adiós a la Coca-Cola y a todos esos productos, ¿no? Súper procesados y demás. Entonces, es justo eso, ¿no? Familia, tener cerca a la familia y pasarla bien, hacer bromas, ayuda mucho, ¿no? Alimentarse bien, eso es lo que puedo decir.
Gracias, Alex, por todo lo que estás diciendo, lo que nos compartiste. Voy a intentar a resumirlo de mejor forma posible. So I'm going to try to sum up everything that he said. But basically, the first month of the fight was emotionally and physically draining. There were lots of conflicts, but in general it just drained all the life out of you. But what gives, after moving forward, what gives him hope, what gives him inspiration, and what gives him strength to keep on going, one of course is the family that is vital and that keeps you whole as a person, and then of course the collective movement that just keeps everyone moving forward, being together, a united front as a group, and knowing that you're fighting for the right cause. Gracias, Alex. So, José Milán, si puedes responder, ¿qué te mantiene sano en toda la lucha que estás haciendo?
Pues, a mí me mantiene sano el río. Estar en el agua para mí es lo máximo. estar en el río y estar con mi familia, a mí me mantiene sano. A mí las cuestiones monetarias, aunque desgraciadamente hoy en día todo está monetizado y todos necesitan o necesitamos del dinero, para mí no es lo más importante. La felicidad para mí está en la naturaleza, en el río. Mi vida está en el río. Y ver correr todavía la cuenca de la Antigua libre, a mí me da mucha salud. Para mí es lo máximo. Entonces, eso fue como una medicina que me ayudó a curarme después de esto que decía Alex, de lo que pasamos al inicio de la lucha, porque fue muy estresante, fue muy agobiante, fue cansado, pesado, pero ver la cuenca que seguía libre y estar dentro de ella, disfrutar y convivir con ella, cada vez que lo hago, me mantiene sano. Eso es para mí lo que me mantiene vivo.
Gracias, José. Thank you so much, José, for sharing that with us. So what keeps José healthy is the river, interacting with the river that keeps him and his family alive, watching his family play in the river, and during the intense months that of the fight in which they were really pushing for the change within the community and pushing the Mexican government, pushing the corporations to stand back, it was the river and that connection to the land that kept him strong. Gracias, José. And then José Alfredo Moral García Sajorín is just joining us. He unfortunately had jumped off and had trouble getting connected back to the conversation. But Sajorín, I'm going to actually ask you another question, just because we know we're getting to the very end of this panel. I want to ask you, what brings you hope? Te quiero preguntar, Sajorín, José Alfredo, ¿qué te trae a ti esperanza?
Okay. A mí lo que me trae esperanza es que hagan colectivos haciendo este y difundiendo este tipo de eventos, la importancia que se le da a nuestra madre tierra, eso a mí me da esperanza. Del conocimiento de nuestros abuelos, de nuestras abuelas, me trae esperanza. El que los niños que expresan versión entre la naturaleza, eso me trae esperanza. Como profesor, como activista socioambiental, como Colpret, tratamos de que nuestras actividades vayan encaminadas al impacto de la conciencia infantil, porque consideramos que ellos son las semillas de grandes árboles. Eso me trae esperanza.
Gracias, José. So what brings hope to José Alfredo is one, that there are collectives like the ones that are present here that are doing this vital work to share these stories and make these stories real for everyone. And also, what also brings him hope is, well, he's a teacher, he's an educator, is the children, the youth that are learning these stories and are bringing forward this future. That's what gives José Alfredo hope. Gracias, José. Alejandro, could you join us again? We're going to wrap everything up. Lo que quieren ver en el futuro. Si ven el futuro de unos 20 años, el futuro de sus hijas, hijos, ¿qué quieren ver para ese futuro? So I'm asking them, in 20 to 30 years, what future do they want to see for their children and their communities? ¿Qué futuro quieren ver para sus hijas, hijos y para su comunidad en 20, 30 años? So we're going to start with Alejandro. What future? ¿Qué futuro, Alejandro?
Bosques, tierras diversas, vida diversa y culturas diversas, que los pueblos sigan siendo diversos y tengan sus propias raíces y puedan compartirlas con los demás.
So, forest communities that are diverse. Diverse communities that are still rooted in their ancestors and in their culture, and that these communities can still keep bringing hope to the future and to the world. Thank you, Alejandro. Gracias, Alex. Georgina?
well, a resilient community that makes possible that environmental is more important than the actual progress, no? Because environmental is the first thing we have to think about. It's only a phrase.
thank you, Gina.
Gracias.
Entonces, Alex Gallardo. No, tu micrófono está apagado.
Ya, listo. Bien, me gustaría, la palabra es respeto, respeto hacia la madre naturaleza y todo lo que conlleva eso. Eso diría.
Alex's dream can be summed up in one word, respect. Respect for Mother Nature and for us all. Gracias, Alex.
Gracias, placer.
José Milán, tu esperanza para el futuro.
Yo creo que lo importante para seguir adelante con este tipo de luchas es no perder identidad. Seguir manteniendo esa identidad, porque mientras sigamos manteniendo identidad, vamos a seguir manteniendo estas luchas y vamos a seguir resistiendo y vamos a seguir cuidando de las montañas, de los lagos, de los mares, de los ríos, de toda la naturaleza. Yo quiero ver en 20 años, en 30 años, en 50 años, en 100 años, que las cuencas que sigan libres, que los bosques que todavía existen sigan existiendo y que las futuras generaciones que vienen atrás de nosotros sigan disfrutando de esto, porque de lo contrario no podemos seguir viviendo. Pero para mí es eso, no perder identidad para poder seguir resistiendo.
So what Jose is saying, that his hope is that all the watersheds, the forests, the communities keep on existing, and that they keep on being free. That's his hope for the future.
And last but not least, José Alfredo, si quieres compartir tu esperanza para el futuro.
Okay, con Gallardo, que es el respeto, pero para el futuro quiero ver más personas conscientes y responsables de su entorno. Quiero que efectivamente, como decía el compañero Milán, no perder la identidad, sobre todo el amor a las cosas, y que el hombre sea ecológicamente sano. Eso espero para el futuro.
José is saying the same thing, that the respect, the importance of respect, and for people not to lose identity, and to keep on preserving the land.
One word, una palabra. Si tienen que compartir algo de su movimiento a esta cuenca o otras cuencas. If you are going to share something from where you are about this to people from this watershed or other watersheds, ¿cuál sería esa palabra? Una palabra que si quieren compartirlo con el mundo. A word to share with the world. Alejandro Beltrán Cordero.
Comunidad.
Community. Gina.
Networking.
La red. Networking. Alex Gallardo.
Que lo hagan con el corazón.
To speak with the heart. José Milán.
Lo mismo que Alejandro, es lo que pensaba igual. Corazón.
Heart. He agrees with Alejandro. Heart. José Alfredo.
Unidad. Somos uno.
We are all one. And so like that, we'll end our night. Gracias a todos, a todas. Thank you everyone for joining us. This is the conclusion of the North Country Art, Land and Environment Summit, a summit in which we joined our voices from the region and the world to think about our collective future. Gracias a todos, gracias a todas. Oh, thank you, someone else is joining us. Gracias por estar con nosotros para concluir esta noche, concluimos esta conferencia, pero también en que unimos mundos. Este mundo, el otro mundo, unimos, cruzamos fronteras y lo hacemos uno. Thank you everybody, and I hope you all have an amazing night. Gracias.